r/AskReddit. People who were adopted when they were old enough to remember it. How long did it take for your adopted family to feel like your family? I was 6. My sister 11. She took to them right away, but it took me about 6 months. This is abnormally long, but because they were the 4th family to try and adopt us, I thought I was going back into foster care, so I had an irrational hatred of them for several months. Now 14 years later, I am very glad they adopted my sister and I. My girl came to us at 4Y. She called me dad from the beginning, but the real switch was after 2Y living with us. My best friend was adopted. Not sure how accurate my response is since it's secondhand information. But she always struggled to fit into her family. Her parents and 2 sisters are blonde with soft features. And she's Eastern European with pitch black hair. Fair skin and a sharp face. Even though she was adopted young. Her 2 sisters are much closer with each other. She spoke frequently about feeling left out and different. Her family are very practical. Salt of the earth people. While she's quite eccentric. I remember at a sleepover. She pointed at a beautiful family portrait over the fireplace. She said that nobody realizes she remembers having that portrait taken. Even though she's 3 or 4 in the photo. She remembers they took 2 photos, one with and one without. So they could use the second one just in case the adoption didn't go through. When we were teenagers, she put an enormous amount of effort into finding her birth mother. And eventually did. I don't know what happened during the meeting. But I know it wasn't what she was expecting. I asked if they were going to meet again. And she said no. She looked crushed. And never mentioned finding her biological relatives again. It took about a year for me. I didn't really feel like they were my family until I was 13. I had met them at 12. And I asked my stepsister for advice on how to ask a girl out. I know it sounds stupid, but that was when it really clicked that they were family and I could trust them. I was adopted 3 months from Korea into an Italian family. Always was told I was adopted, even though that might have been obvious. When you're a baby toddler little kid, you don't understand. I've never felt less loved. Less of a family member, etc. First question people ask is, do you wonder about where your mom is? No, she's at work or at home. My biological mother is probably somewhere in Korea. I don't speak Korean and really don't embrace the culture. I have zero desire to go there or seek out my biological mother. Seeing as I don't speak the language. Have no idea if she's alive. And wouldn't want to hurt my family. Just my personal belief opinion. I'm not sure if this counts, but my dad left when I was about 1 year old. Even during that year, he was barely ever around. My mom has taken great care of me. And still does. I'm 15. When I was younger, it was really hard for my 3-year-old brain to understand why I didn't have a dad like all my other friends. I was pretty upset about it as I got older and my mom and grandparents started to realize it. My granddad really stepped up and started to hang out with me and just be with me more in general. We still spend a lot of time together because he's been the only man in my life and he means the world to me. I know this probably doesn't count as an adoption story, but I felt like I should share it. I was adopted at age 9 and it took a little time. I got to watch movies with my new parents for the first time and I felt uncomfortable calling them mom or dad for ages. It took almost 20 years until I started saying dad, and it still feels a little weird calling him that. But don't get me wrong. He's my dad and I love him. I wasn't officially adopted. I kind of adopted him. But I spent every summer with my uncle since I was 5. Then I lived with him for a short bit, and then as a teen he became my legal guardian and I lived with him through high school. He got me because I was a troubled kid teen, and when I was 19 I was sitting in jail and he just kept on showing up to see me. And not to harass interrogate me, he used to harass me in letters, or anything. Just to check on me and entertain me. And I kind of thought, man. I can't shake this guy. I've called him dad since around that time. My cousins are my siblings to me too. That came before I figured out who my dad was. I have a little brother who was fully adopted by him too. He just kind of tripped and fell into our family and became a part of us. From my perspective, it became pretty normal pretty quickly to have him around for family stuff. Not until I was 18. I met them when I was 14. the summer going into my freshman year of college. It felt like a choice they made and not an obligation to the state. I was adopted really late, like 20, and I felt like I was theirs from day one. They felt it too. I didn't move in straight away. In fact, I was living elsewhere and would go to them on weekends only for about 6 months before I fully moved in. I will never forget how much they loved me and I thought I was so special. They were older white Jewish Americans and I was a small African kid from Kenya. But it worked out perfectly and they are more than my parents. They are really like incarnations of God to me. I am what I am mainly because of them. I am so privileged in loving me. They taught me how to love, but I always felt super special from day one. Fast forward 5 years and I met my husband, and guess what? They love him the exact same way and have basically adopted him as well. My mom told me a month ago, "M is our favorite person." And I was like, "What about me? I thought I was your favorite person." And she was like, "You are our daughter. You're not our favorite person. LMAO. I love her suiru much." My parents both remarried when I was 9, and so I have extensive step families. I don't know if this is the same. I considered them my family pretty quickly afterwards. Although I recently found out that my stepdad's mother doesn't consider me her grandchild. 22 years later. I was about 9 years old when I was adopted. My sisters and my brother came with. At the time, I didn't realize just how crazy my new parents were for deciding to adopt all four of us at once. Now that I'm older, I can safely say that we've given both of them absolute hell all throughout our teenage years. Honestly, not being separated from my siblings made the transition kind of seamless. We'd been in the foster care system for only about 8 months and were more or less oblivious to what was going on. Then we were introduced to some people who wanted to be our new parents. 1 week we were visiting these two nice people. The next we were living with them and visiting all our new relatives. I know that it might sound kind of bland, but there was maybe only a period of a couple weeks where I had to get comfortable with thinking of these strangers as family. Maybe it helped that I was a relatively dumb kid. Or maybe my new family being so closely knit with each other helped. Hell. My new grandparents lived next door to us until we moved to a bigger house. My grandmother passed and her best friend for 27 years took us in. It took me about a couple months before I really got comfortable and started seeing them as family. Because even though I knew of them, I didn't actually know them. Really curious to know as I'd like to adopt in the future. Well, I was never adopted, but I did spend an exchange year in the US with a lovely American host family. I would say it went super fast. Maybe 3-4 months in we were family. The first time I cried my eyes out, because I was so homesick. They tried my tears and spent the entire night comforting me. That was the night I knew they were my family. 12 years since my exchange year and I still call them mom and dad. It never did, sadly. It was just incompatibility, even though I was very very young, a toddler less than 2, and honestly we just never fit. I don't love them and I never did. I wanted to so badly. They felt the same way, I am sure. I always wondered if I was broken until I had my own family and found my bio siblings. I felt it then. Either we just had really different personalities. They were loud sports people. Mother wanted a girly girl pageant queen like the rest of the women in her family line. I am a quiet reader who is super interested in frogs. I left home at 17 and we haven't spoken to each other in years since I was 30-ish. I wish them well. Eater again, I didn't know I was adopted until 18. I feel a very strong connection to my bio family that I found when I was 18. Not my bio parents, useless dart. I found siblings with my same sense of humor and my nieces so much like me it is scary. I had adopted siblings with me but they were always like strangers even though we grew up together. I have a complicated situation where my old ex-stepdad was the one who adopted me after my mother decided she was going to run off to Montana. Since I lived with him as a preschooler when him and my mom were married, I considered him my father. So the opposite to the ups question was what happened. I had to understand that he wasn't my father. My biological father was a rich kiddish adult who I have met 3 times before he died. It took me 8 years to think of the man who adopted me to not be my biological father, but he is still my father nonetheless. I wasn't old enough to remember. But my treatment in Russia left me emotionally dependent, emotionally distant. I never cried. My adopted family felt like my family by the time I turned like, probably 5 or 6. This stopped when I turned 11. Now I call her mom out of habit. As in bio foster adoptive. These replies make me so happy. There are a lot of people who have negative feelings about adoption and feel entitled to tell you their opinion on how awful it is. I am always happy to hear when the middle chapters of kids' lives are happier for it. I moved into a foster home when I was 12. And lived there for a little more than 1 year. I never really felt like they were my family since I knew I wasn't going to stay there until I was 18. But I can easily say that it's the best place I've ever lived at. Every year before the year I moved in, there is just a big blur filled with anxiety and what I would call very mild PTSD. I can't handle two people raising their voices at each other or someone's muffled voice through a wall without getting very anxious anymore. But the past 5 years since I moved in, there is as clear as tap water that isn't from Flint, Michigan. This is a shit show to read. But I hope you'll understand. It's 1:30 a.m. and I'm really tired. So I'll fix any grammatical errors tomorrow if I'll remember it. I felt accepted immediately. When I left my biological parents when I was 3, I did not like them. Whenever they fought, I would go out and wait for the local sheriff department to arrive to stop it. After a few times, the sheriff's department took me, giving me to CPS and arrested my bio mom. I spent 4 months or 5 months in foster care in CA, bumping around to a new home every month. But the family that adopted me got me shortly before my birthday as an emergency call, as CPS wanted me to be in a stable home for my birthday. My family fell in love with me as soon as I arrived. The next morning I walked up to my dad and asked him, "Hi Jim. Where's mom?" Not much longer after that I called him dad. I was in limbo for a bit, but by kindergarten my family adopted me. When they did adopt me, I wouldn't have ever considered leaving. They were my home and my family. My siblings, who are much other than me, treated me like I always was there. My family, and more specifically my mom and dad, gave me a much better life than I ever would have had. I wonder why Op deleted his account already. About 2 months. That's when I asked if I could call her mum. She cried and I felt bad because I didn't know happy tears were a thing when I was 5. Edit. Wow, my first gold in 5 years. Thank you, kind strangers. Sorry I made you all cry, haha. Get your tissues ready, guys. And something to wipe your nose tears ready. Not adopted, but have a similar-ish situation. My mom got a divorce from my biological dad and remarried a couple of years later. I was 4 or 5 at the time and remember this because the following year that they got married, my biological dad died. Extremely traumatic for me. Anyway, I wanted to keep my dad's last name and not change it. And my mom was okay with it. But the step family hates me for it. 11 years and 3 younger brothers later, they still hate me and treat my brothers like gods. My mom understands and lets me slink home after a while. But I hate my stepdad. He lays in bed all day playing Fortnite and Pokemon Go and expects my mom to do everything perfectly, and when she does, he still finds a way to complain. I have a younger cousin who is a couple months younger than the oldest younger brother. She will lie about petty things and blame it on me, such as she stole my doll when I didn't, and the family will punish me for it. The punishment is watching everyone else eat and not being able to eat dinner. I know this probably shouldn't count, but I know how it feels to be rejected. I know someone that was adopted. This is not a good happy type though. We worked together and eventually lived together. We did everything together. She was adopted as a baby, and when she was either 9 or 11, her adopted dad killed her adopted mother. She was their only child. She was then passed through the family and she mostly stayed with the mother's sister. They had quite a bit of animosity toward the dad for killing her sister and refused to let her speak with him while he was in jail. He did almost 20 years and they started to repair the relationship. They were extremely close and she forgave him years before. He went on to marry again and it was hard for my friend. He passed away not too long ago. I always had a soft spot for her dad and her. They had been through a lot of pain. My mom tried to find her parents, but all the cases were closed. I haven't talked to her in a while, I think I'll call her now. As a teen who was adopted from foster care, I didn't say I love you back to my parents for years and didn't refer to them as my parents until I was well into my 20s. It's not that I didn't love them or view them in that way. Because I absolutely did, but I think I was afraid to or didn't want to associate them with my bio parents who had hurt me so deeply. I had been living with them for maybe a year plus as a foster family. I was leaving for the second, out of state, VI sit with a prospective adoptive family and we were all crying. I turned 12 in time to have a say about it, in Ohio, and still have the half inch thick file of letters and papers supporting me going to the right family. So, a little more than a year. Speaking for my brother, so you're getting secondhand information. But we're fairly close now. My brother was always kind of the different duckling. We adopted him from a willing family who knew they weren't fit to raise him properly. And at the time his mother was into drugs. This had some side effects for my brother's mental and physical health since she had done some drugs while pregnant with him. This made it difficult for him to adjust. I think even today he doesn't quite feel like he fit in anywhere. Not just our family. So it's hard to say if he ever got that sigh of relief moment. That said, I think it took him a little longer into when he started maturing to figure out all the things our parents did for him. But since our siblings just considered him our brother right out of the gate, I think he at least saw us as his siblings pretty quickly after adoption. So it definitely took a long time for him to see our parents as his own parents proper. But his siblings he saw as family pretty soon. Even if he felt estranged because of his conditions. They never did. I don't remember it, but my biological parents were 18/19 at the time and my adoptive parents were not able to conceive. Thus, a day after I was born, they took me home. I have been here since. I was adopted at birth. But I remember my birth mother telling me she was going to kill herself until she found out she was pregnant with me. So I saved her life technically. She also has my name tattooed on her back. My nephew is adopted, 1 year adoption next week. And he is 4. He's at this weird age where he knows he didn't start with us but from the very first meeting called my brother dad and my parents gramps and granddad. Through his own choice. Not anything he's been made to do. I hope he always just remembers how loved he is and never had to question when he became a part of the family, as there I can barely remember a time he wasn't a part of ours. About a week in when they told me I didn't have to ask permission every time I wanted food. I was like, well, this is family. My mom was adopted when she was 14. Her whole life. Her adopted mother reminded her that she would never be a part of the family. She's now 50 and doesn't talk to anyone on her side. They're all toxic fucks. Not adopted. But when I was young, 4 to 5 years, my family would always tell me that I was adopted from a beggar. And every time we passed by a homeless lady, they'd tell me that. This is your mum. We just found you in the trash. And I believed that. And late at night I ran away to find my real parents. I got lost and another family found me and called the cops to check on me. So they reunited me with my parents and guess what? They started scolding me for not giving the police the address. Like WTF. Well, IDK if it counts, but my aunt and uncle sent CPS when I was like 3 and I didn't know what to do and I thought I was just having a sleepover. Fast forward a couple of years and I look up my dad's name on my old iPad and it said his name then arrest, so I came in and then they told me, but after that I started calling them mom and dad because they were what I had. I have 3 sisters. And we all had bounced around from one family member to another when we were kids. Often staying at my aunt and uncle's house. But at 13. I moved in with them for good. They were young. 24 maybe. With 2 kids of their own. Although we had always been close. And they made every effort to teach me what it means to be family. It didn't hit me until I was about 18. They gave to the trend of putting family stickers on the back windshield of their car. And I had my very own little stick person. To me. That meant that they were telling the world I was their kid. And that they were proud to have me. They later adopted my youngest sister. And recently when I asked how she felt about being adopted. She said. I might not have come from them. But they know me. and out of every kid in the world, they chose me. As someone who had never been in a proper household, I never did adjust to the lifestyle. I'm not adopted, but my little brother is. He didn't speak any English when my parents brought him home, but I remember feeling like he was family pretty quickly. It might be because we knew he was coming for 2 years beforehand. So it was almost like I knew him before I met him. I was 10 when he was adopted. All these stories make me wish someone had adopted me. My mother kicked me out at 13 because she was angry with me after my stepfather sexually assaulted me and I turned him into police. I'm 37 now and my mother still tells people I ruined her life. It would be pretty amazing to feel the love of a family. I'm glad so many people found that. I was adopted by my dad when I was 11. My dad is the father of my brother but not me. I was told rather coldly by my mom. Sadly, she is my bio mom. I checked at 8 that my dad wasn't my real dad. It wasn't as devastating to me. I have connected with my older bio sister. She is my family for sure. My mom died when I was 13 and my sister and I went to live with my aunt and uncle and their kids. So technically we were already family. My sister was younger and easier to deal with than me and they definitely treat her like part of the immediate family. They frequently made me feel like a burden. They wouldn't do things like drive me to or from friends' house so I would have to walk alone at night. They didn't really celebrate my birthday. I did my college tours alone. One of my cousins is the same age as me and when she went to tour her college they wouldn't let her go alone. She got upset and asked why I was allowed to take trains and buses and travel out of state by myself and she couldn't. My uncle said because we care about you. Last year, I'm 27 now, we did a family trip to Vegas and they told me to bring a sleeping bag and I had to sleep on the floor of the hotel and my cousin crashed my rental car. And I was found at fault. So I guess never. TLDR. Never. Not sure if this counts but my husband's family adopted me. I met my current husband online. While living with my very toxic and emotionally abusive family. I was at rock bottom. Suicidal and had scarring on my arm from self-harm. One day while we were Skyping. I jokingly asked if I could move down to live with him. He still lived with his parents, we were only 21 at the time, but he was an only child and they told him I could live with them. I took my piggy bank plus all the savings I had and bought a one-way plane ticket here. They took me in and even gave me my own bedroom, they had a spare bedroom, even though I mostly slept with my then boyfriend. It's been 4 years since then and I am so grateful. It took me about 2 years to finally feel like I fit in with this family, I'm Asian and they're white. Just now, after stumbling across this post, I realize that they've adopted me. I love them so much. This whole comment section is reminding me of this Gabriel Iglesias story. Gabriel speaking to his girlfriend's son. So, have you ever wanted to meet your real dad and talk to him? Son. But Gabriel. You are my real dad. Honestly, never felt anything for my birth family, so right away I felt like my adopted family was mine. Wasn't adopted. Just went to foster care. The people were psychos. I had a little sister about 3 and we stayed there for a month. They never fed my little sister and cause I stole food for her I was put into the empty pool for a day and a half. Mind you, this was winter. Then there were other kids about the same age as me. I was 7. There were 3 girls and we all had to share the bath. I wore my swimsuit, and then one girl ripped it off. Let's just say it was bloody after that. I bashed her up. Don't worry, me and my sister are safe now living with our grandparents. I moved in with my dad at around 3. I remember feeling like he was a stranger my mom really liked. He really loved me and my brother like his own and would take us to work with him every morning when we were old enough. We would call him by his name for years and when we got a little older I started to realize that maybe he was our dad. I didn't know why we didn't call him dad like other kids. Just thought we weren't allowed to. Every morning that he couldn't take us to work, we'd say bye. Jim. One morning. I thought about saying dad instead of Jim but wasn't sure if I was allowed. But my brother. Always the go-getter. Said bye daddy. And I said it right after him. We were about 5-6 years old. Later in life I learned that he cried to my mom that we finally called him daddy and unprompted. Unfortunately, he wasn't able to legally adopt us until I was 19. But he has always been daddy since that morning. Never. I was 10 years old at the time. They felt like my family within the week. Cause unlike my blood family, they were able to actually take care of me. I was adopted when I was 8 years old along with my biological sister, 5. This past July was my 40-year anniversary of our adoption. I can honestly say that from day one I felt like part of the family. After flying in from Korea in the middle of the night, I woke up to a warm and bright July morning. Aside from the language barrier, life was blissful. For the first time in several years, I felt safe and loved. I basically won the lottery with my amazing family. My dad is my hero and my mother's love is so amazing. My parents are getting up in their years and I try my best to repay them for everything they ever did for me, but I know I never will. On the 40th anniversary, my dad gave me this hug. He was shaking with emotion, told me how much he loved me. Like I said, won the lottery. I was 1.5. And I remember my first Christmas. I was 22 months. Never really knew my birth mother. Not actually adopted. But my family kinda sucks. There's this one guy I've known since we were both about 3 years old. But he lives about 150 miles away from me. Recently-ish, I had a fight with my mom. And she called up my friend's family and started shit-talking me. My friend's mom is a social worker. And based on how she reacted later, I got the feeling that a lot of very specific alarm bells were going off in her head. Looking back, it's probably not the first time those alarm bells went off either. Anyway, they ended up letting me stay with them for the next 6 weeks. The week I was set to leave, she sat down with me and said, "I know you're going to be out of school soon. You are always welcome in our house." I don't know if I'll ever actually call them mom and dad, but their house with them definitely feels like home. My cousins were 5 and 2, and the one who was 5 is 18 now and remembers the adoption. Well, the adoption was a years long process, so the 2-year remembers some of that too. But the 5-year remembers arriving to my aunt and uncle's as a foster child. I met them maybe a week after they'd arrived. The 5-year wasn't calling my aunt mom yet. He wasn't really calling her anything. But he called me sissy immediately. I was 13 or 14. To this day he's not really able to articulate why. He says he just felt like he should call me that. This doesn't answer the question, haha, but I always liked that little story. He began calling my aunt and uncle mom and dad within the first year. And stopped asking if there was enough food for him and for his brother, something he asked the very first time he was served cereal at their home and continued to ask almost every meal, within 6 months. The first night I got to sleep in my bed, in my room, with my toys. It helped that it was my kindergarten teacher. I was 4 when I was adopted and it took a couple of months. My elder brothers, also adopted, used to give me extra sweets and food from their plates. It's something I had never experienced before. It was incredible. I had never experienced that sort of love from anyone before. Immediately, I was adopted by 2 older women. One Cherokee Indian and the other head of CPS for 40 years. Since retired. 2 very interesting ladies. They were best friends since the 60s. My mother was schizophrenic and her abuse was out of fear and hallucinations. In the beginning they did everything to turn my mother around so she could take care of me. But her mental state worsened. They soon visited me every week. Paying for long overdue medical appointments and shots. Food, clothes that fit, and trauma therapy. My mom called them my grandmas and I began to love them just as much as I did her. When I was 10 my mom officially signed me over, but still got visitation. They saved my life definitely. I know I'm a different kind of adoption case. But short answer was that I loved them instantly. They treated my mother like a human being. Not a monster. And gave me everything they had. I lost one of them in 2005 to cancer. Her name was Mary. And have been taking care of the other since she turned 70. I don't want to get pregnant, so I'm thinking about adoption. but I'm really scary of getting a kid too old so they won't feel like belonging or that I'm not their mother. This is really important to me. Thank you for asking. Still doesn't. My stepmom is terrible to my dad and blatantly disrespects him. He's not allowed to hang out with his guy friends, but she can hang out with her girlfriends. It's gotten ridiculous. Hello. Half adopted here. It was really easy. My stepdad was there as long as I could remember. He felt like more my family than my biological dad, who even during visits was a stranger. My sister and I asked to be adopted. I even wrote a persuasive essay explaining why I wanted to be adopted and presented it to my 6th grade English class. I was 12. We hit our 10 years anniversary next week. I, 16, was adopted like a year ago by my best friend's family. I'm black and they're Puerto Rican. Not sure if that's important, but whatever. It's weird because like 80% of the time they feel like my family. But then there's the 20% where I remember my past and all of the sudden feel disconnected from them. Kind of reverse, we adopted our son at birth. So he wasn't old enough to remember. But it still speaks to the how long did it take to bond question. I wanted to adopt, but I was secretly afraid of not bonding. I had read a book and some articles about how hard it is caring for an infant you don't even love yet. Well, I swear it was happening before I even met him. As soon as I got the call, I was bonding with him. And then we walked in and saw this tiny little perfect baby. And my heart just melted. He was mine, ours, no doubt about it. I loved him instantly. And my husband did too. My entire family loves him the same. Anyway, I'm it sure this fits here, but I thought, why not share my story? I was adopted at 17. My foster family I was staying with had shown more love and devotion to me in 3 years than my own mom did in the 17 years I had been alive. I just knew it was the right thing to do. My mom never showed up to court meetings. She took my stepdad's side regarding my abuse. She constantly would make visitation plans with me and then drop them. She did her best my whole life to remind me that I was her mistake. And even though she constantly made me feel unwanted and alone, she still tried to refuse to sign away her rights to me. My county worker almost didn't allow the adoption to go through. And in all that time, my foster parents reminded me that the outcome didn't matter. I'd always have a spot in their home and heart. And honestly, I have never looked back. Aside from missing my half-brother and sister very much. Unfortunately, we are no contact because my mom and stepdad have it in their heads that I ruined their lives. My city worker got my caseworker to get her head out of her ass. Got my mom to sign me away. And I have been a happy addition to my new family ever since. Never. I always knew I was adopted, and I was adopted from a very young age. I was never able to develop healthy attachments to a caregiver due to the number of foster homes and neglect. I have respect for my adopted family. But the only capacity I have learned for love or a familial connection is with my cat and my now fiancé. Having a very rough adoption process matched with bad parenting causes a lot of miscommunication and lack of family bonds. I like them a lot and I have a better relationship now that I am an adult, but that's as far as it goes. Maybe I feel more like a family now some 19 years later. I don't know what the future will be like though. Not long I had been friends with the oldest son for several years. They brought me in and immediately treated me like family. My birth mother had dropped my brother and I off with them for months at a time. I was pretty acclimated before I ever moved in. I'm not adopted, but my parents were irresponsible and I started living with my uncle at the age of 9. He emotionally and physically abused me. My dad also has 6 other children, all older than me, from different marriages, and none of them were fully raised by him. Always felt a part of the family. But even more so when my nan happily patted my stomach and exclaimed, "You're getting the family belly. I miss you, Nan." Not sure if I am correct about this, but I have an adopted sister. Total pain in my ass growing up. She was between 10 to 12 when my parents adopted her. I had 2 other sisters, so another one just seemed like a small issue, to be honest. Well, after the adoption was finalized, she became a demon. Since I was the oldest, I was in charge of trying to get her to learn multiplication. She would just scream and scream. I finally gave up at some point and my parents got her into an after-school program to help her. The house just felt tense and full of anger for about 2 years. She's getting married in 2 weeks. Recently she thanked me for being patient with me. I'm a bridesmaid. I told her that all little sisters must first be a pain in the ass in order to ever be considered sisters. Not long once I realized they saved us, me and my 2-year-old sister at the time. I was 8. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for daily awesome videos, feel free to like the video if you love it, and comment down below for suggestions on the next video.